Hey guys, and welcome back to my channel. My name is Shamir Elaine. For those of you who are new, for those of you who are not new, thank you all so much for coming back and supporting everything I do here on my channel. In today's video, I am going to be sharing with you all how I maintain my locks so that they are nice, healthy, full, and long. It's one thing to wash, retwist, shampoo, get them styled. It's another thing to take care of them when you aren't doing those things. So before we get into this video, one, make sure that you're subscribed to my channel. While you're at it, hit that notification bell so that you're notified every single time that I upload. Two, make sure you give this video a big old thumbs up. And three, make sure you leave me a comment down in the comment section below. So let's just get into this video. So these are all things that I personally use to maintain my locks. One, so that they're not falling out. Two, so that I can pretty much keep it up and keep it fresh for as long as possible, so I'm not retwisting or washing my hair too often. And three, I just want them to look nice. I want them to look nice and I want them to grow. That is my main goal. So the first thing that I do to actually maintain my locks is I always wear a silk scarf to bed. That is a must. That's number one. I know way too many people with locks who sleep without a scarf on their head. I think it's just this assumption that is not needed since the hair is pretty much doing its own thing. I know a lot of people actually sleep in the pineapple method with their locks, but I think that you really do need a satin scarf when you're going to bed. I was natural before this, so I had my fro, and if you're natural and you're watching this, you know if you sleep without a scarf, it's a done deal. One, the hair gets matted. Two, even if, like, if you are not wearing a satin scarf and you're sleeping on a pillow that is not satin, the hair tends to snag and come out. If you're not sleeping with a satin scarf or a satin pillow, your hair is prone to fall out. One thing that you can do is, if you are not wearing a satin scarf and you don't have a satin pillow and you have locks, literally look at the pillow when you wake up. If you see those little bitty hairs on the pillow or the bed, that means that your hair is slowly coming out, and to prevent that, you should wear a scarf. If you are someone who doesn't prefer to wear scarves, just get a satin pillowcase. That way you can eliminate your hair actually falling out. Another reason that I like to wear a satin scarf to bed is because I personally don't do my edges. I don't do the baby hairs or anything like that. So I find that actually wearing a satin scarf to bed kind of helps slick back my edges without any product. That's pretty much my personal hack for real slick, not even real slick, but just in place slick edges without any product. This is the silk scarf that I use. It just looks like this. I have been using this for a pretty long time, and I'm pretty sure you can get a silk scarf from the beauty supply. You can get it from pretty much anywhere, but you want to make sure that it is silk. The second thing that I do to maintain my locks is I make sure to oil my scalp every 3 to 4 days. Now, if you've been watching my previous lock videos, I have been showing you all the oil that I am currently using, which is the Butterfly Growth Oil from a Black-owned woman business called Avenue 51 Beauty. I absolutely love the oil, y'all, because it has a lot of natural ingredients, and it also has biotin, which helps to promote hair growth. My hair tends to get dry and flaky really easily, so if I go too long without oiling my scalp, it gets so dry and my flakes become even bigger. So I make sure to literally oil my scalp every three to four days. If I go 5-6 days, I can tell because my hair starts to get itchy, my scalp starts to get itchy, and it starts to get like a little bit white because it's too dry. I also make sure that I oil my scalp every 3 to 4 days, because once I start to see that my scalp is getting too dry, I start to see a lot of buildup, which causes my hair to be dirty. And if my hair is dirty, y'all, I gotta wash my hair. It could be 2 weeks since I did my last retwist and my hair would be dirty, and I'm just like, yeah, no, I have to wash it. So that's why I try to keep myself on a strict routine of oiling my scalp every 3 to 4 days, because I hate washing my hair too soon. I don't like washing my hair and retwisting my hair when I really don't need to. I do have a coupon code for the Butterfly Growth Oil, but their website is currently down because they are waiting for their anniversary sale to restock everything. So I'm still going to include it down below, but I will definitely make sure to check out their Instagram, even follow them on Instagram so you know when the Butterfly Growth Oil drops, okay? Because it sells out every time. Every time it sells out. It's that good. The third thing that I do to maintain my locks is I wear my scarf in the shower. Not only do I wear it to bed, I wear it in the shower, okay? The main reason for this is because if you are natural, you know that when water or humidity, even just as just a little touch of the head, it just poofs and frizzes like there's no tomorrow, okay? And I do not like for my locks to look frizzy, especially at the roots. Ooh, so I always make sure to wear a scarf while I'm in the shower, just because my showers get a little steamy, okay? They get a little steamy and I just don't want my roots, the hair in my roots to get frizzy and stuff like that. Like I told you all before, I like my locks to stay and look as fresh as possible so that I am not constantly retwisting or washing it and preventing water or humidity from getting to it, especially in the shower, is a must for me. The fourth thing that I do to maintain my locks is I wear protective styles and I limit the pulling of my locks. I do love to do two-strand twists on my locks, especially after I get done retwisting, and I usually keep my two-strand twists in for about 2 weeks. If you look at other people who have locks, they may do like a top knot bun or have like braids and stuff like that. I choose not to do that because I don't like the pulling of my locks, especially at my roots. If you all have been tuned into my lock videos, you know that my locks have been thinning and I don't even wear my hair in braids or updos, or I don't even do any of those styles for my hair to be thinning. It makes me not even want to do those styles even more. So I just choose not to do those types of styles. Sometimes I will wear my hair in a ponytail, but it is a very loose ponytail, and then I just stick to the two-strand twist. I also have seen a lot more growth in my hair from just letting them hang like this. I always like make fun of myself or even just criticize myself for just not doing as many styles as I can with my locks. Like, I'll be thinking of some cute ass styles and I will wear it in the house, but only for like a little bit because it's just, I can feel it tugging at my roots and it really hurts, so I just don't do them for a long period of time. But I do think that my hair has grown a lot more when I just let my hair be, if I just wear it down and just leave it alone. So that's another reason why I don't really do any braids or anything like that. I do need to start styling my locks though, because it gets boring. I know y'all probably tired of seeing me with this same like flip to the side. I don't know, I don't even know, this is my signature lock style though. This is the signature look on this channel, but it does get boring, not gonna lie. Okay, you guys, and the last thing that I do to maintain my locks is I don't put any other product in my hair or on my scalp besides the growth oil. I do feel like extra products tend to weigh the hair down and it causes a lot more buildup. It causes a lot more bacteria in the scalp, which means that you're probably gonna have to wash your hair and retwist it a lot sooner than you normally would if you didn't include any products. So yeah, and I think that I'm not including a lot of product in my hair, it doesn't cause a lot of buildup in my actual locks, because I do plan on doing another ACV rinse just to see how well kept or dirty my hair it actually is. I did do an ACV rinse before, so I would highly suggest you all check out that video. I will link it in the cards, but I have not been putting that much product. I've been proud of that. We'll see how that works. Again, I have been reiterating this the entire video. You don't want to get into the habit of washing and retwisting your hair too much. It causes a lot more friction on the actual locks and can cause it to be brittle. It can cause it to thin, and you don't want your locks to fall out. You want your locks to look healthy and thick and full and grow to be a very long length. You don't want these weird size length locks because some have fallen out and some have remained healthy. You know, you want your locks to just overall look nice. You want them to look nice. At least I want my locks to look nice. I do think if you kind of follow along with these 5 tips, it will prevent you from washing and retwisting your hair too often. But yeah, you guys, those were all of the 5 things that I do to maintain my locks in between my wash and retwist. If you all have any questions about what I do to maintain my locks, please make sure to ask them down in the comment section below. If you like this video, make sure you give it a thumbs up. And then if you made it to the end of this video, I want you to comment hair goals, okay? Comment hair goals if you made it to the end of this video. Thank you all so much for tuning into this lock video. Again, make sure you subscribe to my channel and I'll have all of my lock videos in the description box. I hope to see you guys in my next video. Bye.